Hi guys. So I thought I would do a little bit of a tour of my room and my collection, just to show you what I've got on my shelves. I started collecting maybe when I was about 19, so about six-ish years ago. So everything that I've got has been in the last few years. I'm currently running out of space, to be honest, but I'll still find space for more stuff. So let me show you around. So anyone that follows my stuff will know that I'm a big Harry Potter fan. So I've got quite a lot of bits related to Harry Potter now. I've just finished reading all the books, which was the first time I've ever read them. So these little guys were from the Harry Potter Pop Advent Calendar. They're really small, they're sort of like the size of half of my thumb, but I love them. They make a really nice addition to my Harry Potter shelf. Next up are my Q Posket Harry Potter figures. These are some of my favourite figures in the collection. I just think they're really, really cute. And I think they're really well made for the price that you pay for them. I just love the style of them. This is my Harry Potter Nendoroid. He's the only Nendoroid that I have, but he's absolutely gorgeous. I love him. You can change his face, he's got a broom. He's got all different accessories as well as Hedwig, and he's just a really nice addition to the collection. I only have two magical creature figures, so I've got Forks the Phoenix. So you've got him on his perch. I love the box that he's in. It just gives it that extra element of him looking like a creature. And then I've also got a spooky Dementor. You can see he's got Hogwarts in the back. He's really cool. Got a chocolate frog here, which is really awesome, and I'm going to open it up inside and show you what's in there. So inside you've got this awesome packaging, looks exactly like the film, and you've got a squishy chocolate frog. And you've got the wizard card, which is kind of a holographic style. So got a couple of general size pops. You've got Hedwig and Dobby, and you've got two limited edition Harry Potter pops, one with the sorting hat, one with him playing Quidditch. I haven't taken them out of the box, so I actually don't know what the full figures look like because they are exclusives. Speaking of pops, here is my pop collection. One Punch Man pops. Got a Street Fighter, got a couple of anime ones like Sword Art Online, Attack on Titan. Got some Star Trek ones. Blade Runner 2049, which is my favourite film of all time, or one of. Wreck-It Ralph. A few Disney ones, Toy Story. I've got Aloy and one of the machines from Horizon Zero Dawn. Next up is my bookshelf. I'm running out of space a lot, to be honest, so I've had to put a few up there. It's mostly science fiction. My favourite author is Philip K. Dick. But yeah, most of it's science fiction with a few fiction bits. And these are just bits from my travels. And these are the science fiction mystery minis. So I just think they're super awesome and they go really well on my bookshelf. And you've got like Back to the Future and all those bits, Matrix, Predator, Alien, Fifth Element, and then of course we have to have Spock. We have a couple of graphic novels. They're mostly science fiction and cyberpunk. Got Bruce Lee. I love martial art films, so obviously I love Bruce Lee. A big fan of Stranger Things. Don't have a lot of things for Stranger Things at the moment, but this book is one of my favourites. It's an absolutely stunning guide to the Stranger Things series, and it looks like a properly old book that you get secondhand. Got these super cute pins that I bought off of an Etsy shop. Got Gravity Rush there, and we have Danganronpa as well. I'm a big fan of Final Fantasy, so we have Lightning from Final Fantasy 13, I think she's a really cool character. I didn't actually mind Final Fantasy 13, so, bit of a controversial opinion. Here's Sephiroth. Everyone knows where Sephiroth is from. Behind, we have a collector's edition of all the music from Final Fantasy 13. It's a really beautiful collector's edition. I love the pink foil wrap, as you can see. Of course, we have to have an adorable Moogle plush. Then we've got these kind of Chibli Final Fantasy figures. These are some of my favourite figures in my whole collection. I just think they're absolutely adorable. And they're really small, so they fit anywhere. They just make a really nice addition to a collection. All the games here, well, most of them anyway. Then we have Chocobo in an egg. He's adorable. We have a cactus. Now you got a special edition of a Final Fantasy VII remake. And then we've got some Kingdom Hearts figures. These are Funko's 5-star range. They're not the best looking range ever, but they're normally really cheap, and I still think they're pretty cool for the price. And this is, I think he's a Playarts Kai, so obviously it's Sora. He's got his sword, he's got his arrow. He's really cool. So I got a couple of retro consoles here. My favourite retro console, which is the Sega Mega Drive. I just love it. I just feel like it's really nostalgic and it's got some of my favourite retro games on it. I've got my PS2. Obviously, I've got my Spyro Pop, which I love Spyro. Got a few different games, not many. I'm currently looking for Streets of Rage to add to the collection. Echo the Dolphin just kills me every time. But yeah, I love Castle of Illusion, which is behind my Stitch Pop here. These pins were from a Dust Diver Collector's Edition. And obviously, we've got Stitch here in his red spaceship. He's a bit dusty at the moment. You got original PlayStation. Love the look of the original PlayStation instead of the PlayStation 1. Got Collector's Edition of the Wipeout book, which I don't actually have a physical one, which is why I've stuck it up on the wall. These are from the Starlink series. I've got a couple of different pilots and weapons. You have an original Game Boy with a couple of Game Boy games. I don't have many at the moment. Got DS games. Got into Professor Layton again, so that's why I've got a few more now. We've got some Mario figures. These are the only amiibos that I have. So I've just got Splatoon, Animal Crossing, and we've got Link from Link's Awakening with the steelbook that he came with because I got the collector's edition. And you've got mini SNES. And we have Kiryu from Yakuza. Anyone who knows me knows I adore Yakuza. And I'm kind of trying to get Goro Majima at the moment. He's a bit difficult to get hold of, but hopefully soon I'll have him on my collection. So I have a few more books that I just keep on hand to read, and also because I have no more space left in my bookshelf. I've got a PS Vita, obviously. Hi. And we've got my PlayStation 3 and 4. Got different controllers, so this was the 500 million edition controller. Blue's my favorite color, so I try and get any blue controller that I can. Got a Switch, Spyro Cable Guy, which was one of the best purchasing decisions I ever made. And this Ratchet, he's the best plush that I own, I think. Just completely adorable. So this is where all my games belong. I've got quite a few PS2, a couple of PS1s, some PS Vitas, a lot of PS4 games, and a few Switch games. So that was the grand tour of my collection slash room. I hope you guys enjoyed. Let me know down in the comments what is your favorite part of my collection, if anything. And thank you for watching.